And we're live once again. QuadJacks TV. John Harnish. Jonathan Marco. Hey. We meet in person finally.
Yep. Finally
get to
come down here.
From Canada Poker, as it says on your jersey there. Welcome to Las Vegas.
Love Las Vegas.
Why don't you tell us a little bit about what you do?
I do a little bit of reporting on the Canadian poker scene, whether it be in Canada or following the players on the world circuit.
Right.
It's kind of a hobby I enjoy.
You've been on Poker Ray many times.
Quite a few with Mr. Eric Danis.
With Eric Danis.
Fortunately, we miss each other by like 2 days on this
that
trip.
That sucks. Imagine a live Poker Ray right here at the 2012 World Series of Poker. How much fun that would have been.
It would have been awesome.
Right.
But I got
you
to
have
meet
me.
You, and I got to meet Zach, so here we go.
Now, I think that shortly before the World Series of Poker began, it might have been on the last Poker Ray, in fact. It was on the last Poker Ray. You and Eric Danis put together a bit of a preview, Canadian preview of the World Series. Canadian players to watch out for.
Yes.
At the World Series of Poker. So tonight I thought we would go over some of those and see how they've been faring. Kind of like the whole draft updates.
The whole draft updates.
Okay.
Eric looked at a series of articles I'd done, basically took 50 players from across the country and just kind of rated them as the ones to watch or ones to pick. I think right now, over 30 of the 50 have at least cashed. We're probably sitting at about 8 final tables. One bracelet so far. Very close today with Greg Mueller going for the hat trick. That was awesome to watch from the rail. Fortunately, he didn't make it. Do understand he was playing his good friend, so if he had to lose, he had to lose.
Right.
But, you know, Greg still had an awesome summer, right? Second final table, he's like 370,000 in cashes
right.
for the summer. Dream result for most people.
Now, the one bracelet, the one Canadian bracelet was won by Timothy Adams.
And the other by Simon Charest.
Oh, so there's two.
Yeah, there's two.
There's two bracelets. I'm sorry.
There's three total. Today was
three total.
We were going for number four.
Oh, wow. Three total. I'm sorry. I misunderstood you, John Harnish.
Simon Charest was definitely one of the top picks. He runnered up last year, but he had six cashes. He was cashing one in like every 3.5 tournaments he played. Came down, won his first event. First event he played, he won his bracelet.
Yeah.
I don't even know if he's still here. But, like, awesome work.
See, Timothy Adams stood out in my mind because I remember we interviewed him after he won his bracelet. I remember it was Zach who pointed this out, said, like, you know what, you were actually one of the players that our friends John and Eric told us to watch out for at this year's World Series of Poker, and bam, he gets that bracelet.
Philip Bouchard was another one Eric really wanted to, you know, stress. He said, yeah, no, this guy, he's awesome, he's fun to listen to, you know, as he travels. And he's been doing well, too. I think he's on cash number four as of yesterday.
Cool. So, would you say it's a satisfactory performance for Canadian poker? Or would you have liked to see more even by this point?
Well, I'm hoping we break. I believe the record from any non-U.S. company is non-U.S. country is 5 bracelets in a year. And we're at 3 now. We're a little past the halfway mark.
5 bracelets there. Do you know who that is?
I think it was Canada. I believe Canada went in 2011 with the 5 bracelets was the most bracelets won by a non-U.S. country.
2011?
Yes.
Oh, so it was last year.
Last year.
Cool.
And whether I'm right on that stat or not, it'd be nice to see if we can up that here in 2012. We're halfway there, so. Just over half the events done, but, you know, guys are doing well. There's a couple other records that are, you know, a couple Canadians are gunning for, and that would be Terrence Chan and Daniel Adima. Both have put 7 cashes on the board already. Adima thinks that Terrence has a pretty good shot at going for number 8 today. He looked like he was in good shape when he checked on him earlier today, so Terrence may have 8. And the record, according to Nolan Dalla, one of his reports, is 10 in any WSOP season. So, you know, just a little number to shoot for.
Cool.
You can't win a bracelet, you may as well, you know, make some sort of other history. Adima, just doing incredibly as far as looking at his 2011-2012 stats on your QuadJacks WSOP database, he is sitting at about 400,000 in profits. He's cashed in 11 of 25 events that he's played. So, as far as Canadian players go, he was one of the ones we said to watch. And yeah, he's killing it.
Negrano?
Well, he's done well already this year.
Has he?
I thought
he was lamenting that he's you know, kind of dissatisfied with his performance. He's not dissatisfied with his performance. He's satisfied with his performance. He just doesn't think he's running well.
I really like... We still have the one drop coming, right? Mm-hmm. We still have the 50K coming. Those are the events where I think Negrano shines more. The bigger, the harder players, the tougher events, the bigger buy-ins. He just... I mean, you look at his high roller track record, and this is where he really seems to do his best work. Now, I don't know if it's just the difference in the players or the difference in his own attitude, but I think there's the best is yet to come with Negrano as far as these larger buy-ins for this summer.
You mentioned the one drop. That actually does seem like a Canadian tournament, because it's the one drop foundation, and with Guy Laliberté behind it, he's Canadian. He'll be playing it, right?
As far as I know,
so we're going to have at least that one Canadian in the mix.
Yeah.
Negrano. I said Guy. Yeah. How many other... What's that? Timex, Mike McDonald. Are you going to be tracking the Canadian?
Sorrell said he's up the percentage to 9% on the last
Poker A.
And, you know, maybe with some work from his accountant, it could, you know, maybe we could get that to 15%. But Eric kind of broke the story, but the satellite winner, Carlos Najas, I believe it was, who won the Lotto Quebec 25K, has now made an agreement, and I don't even want to try to say this guy's name. He goes by Harbora Bob on Twitter. That's Harbora
Bob Vulgaris.
There you go. That is it. You got her. He's going to be playing for Carlos. So there's Canadian from Winnipeg, living now in the States, but from Winnipeg. So there's another one in the mix. And he was actually one of my ones to watch picks, because when you go through Manitoba, there's not a lot of big players. It's just a smaller population, things like that. So really going through, okay, who has a chance here? His name popped up. Now, I wasn't sure how many events he'd be playing. Talked to him on Twitter. He said he's going to be playing 3 events, and there was a good possibility that one drop was going to be mm-hmm. one of them.
Cool.
Now we know, because Eric's research, now Eric's interview, he is in there. So he's definitely one to watch.
Cool. Absolutely. I can't wait. Listen, we'll be here doing our thing, tracking the one drop, interviewing the players, and Eric will be here as well. I think Eric gets in when the one drop begins, which I think is July 1st.
Yeah. Yeah. Eric gets in 2 days after I leave. I leave on the 28th. He's going to be here on the 30th. So, and the one drop is July 1st.
I miss Poker A, John. I miss it. Do you?
Yeah, definitely. But you know what? There's a little kind of in-between show, and at least come the end of the summer, me and Eric are going to have so much to talk about, right?
Absolutely. No, I cannot wait. I cannot wait. Canadian poker specifically aside, have you been enjoying yourself in Las Vegas so far at the World Series of Poker? I know you've only been here for a few days. But.
Oh, for sure. You know, wife's been out playing. She played the Deep Stacks today. I've already had the opportunity, just being here since yesterday, to meet a lot of the players I've done interviews with and just talk to online and stuff. And that was nice. You know, I talked to Daniel Adima today. I met Sean Buchanan today, Casey Jarzebeck, Eric Cagelet, Mark Radoja. So a few bracelet winners in there from 2011. So it's been really cool to, you know, actually shake hands with these guys and say, you know, thanks for, you know, working on these articles and things like that. And talking to Greg today too. And Greg, I have to say, is probably one of the most stand-up players there is.
Very nice man.
You know, he just busts out of the tournament and he makes a point to come out and talk. And, you know, most guys would be tilting, not want to talk to anybody. Awesome guy. He's just awesome guy.
He is. He really is. You're absolutely right. So, tell us a little bit about the World Poker Tour.
World Poker Tour is coming back to Canada. It's coming...
Why did it ever leave?
You know, that's something that is just tricky.
You sound like you had something to do with it, John Harnish.
No, I didn't chase them out of there. I love the fact that they're back. There's regulations and there's things there that it comes to online poker and things like that. And I... never been in the boardroom as far as what discussions have been, you know, made there, so I couldn't ever answer any questions for them.
We were just photographed.
But they did, They did end up leaving. I mean, they had successful events in both BC and both Niagara, and they were sorely missed, and now they're back. Huge news for us. You know, once the announcement was made, my whole Facebook, my whole Twitter feed, every Canadian that I follow seemed to be talking about it. I mean, it's massively exciting. Montreal is obviously producing so many good poker players. They're the hot spot in Canada as far as, you know, the action right now. The clubs are always going. It's a good fit.
All right. Well, listen, it all sounds great. I can't wait to come hang out in Canada with you guys.
That would be a blast.
That would be fun, wouldn't it?
Yeah.
You think I would have a good time in Canada?
Oh, absolutely.
Why you act like it's so obvious? Do you think you know me that well?
Well, I just don't know anybody that hasn't had a good time
okay.
in Canada.
Okay. Well,
yeah. You know, like, if you like your beers, it's a little stronger.
I do.
You know, they tend to say that we have some very beautiful girls up there.
Is this the same
we're
talk
supposed
that, like,
to be friendly, you know? So
is this the same talk that the Ministry of Tourism in Canada would give me if I were to ask
I
him?
I doubt it.
Strong beers, Marco. Hot women.
Yeah, I doubt it strongly.
strongly.
But you, I think, doing what you do, hang out in this poker environment. I'm going to put it at 90% that you're going to have a great time up there.
I've been known to be a drunkard and a womanizer, so definitely going to have a good time in Canada. John, and I'm looking forward to having a good time with you. You know, you're here for the next couple of days, and, you know, you come and hang out here, and it's good to have you. You know, you're such a fun guy. I'm very glad to have met you. I really am.
Awesome.
And you do excellent work with Canada Poker and on Poker Race, so, you know, good luck to your friends, and we'll be seeing you around again.
Thank you much, sir.
Thanks so much. John Harnish, @JohnTM on the Twitter, QuadJacks TV.